Smith has been removed for the good of the prison. As far as Mrs. Davidson's concerned, well, that wasn't my decision. There's nothing I can do about it.
You better think of something.
This isn't getting you anywhere, Brian.
We're barricaded in here. You can't get in and we're not coming out. And we're on a hunger strike. And we'll stay on it until we see Bea and Mrs. Davidson. So you better do something about it quick, Fletch. Because a hunger strike ain't gonna look too good to the department.
Hey, you in the shower yet?
No, why?
Someone at the door.
Oh my God, it's my parole officer.
Parole officer? Jeez, a pro is just out of the jug. This is my lucky day.
Here, look, if you go in the bathroom, I'll get rid of her.
Oh, no, no way. You're not worth this much trouble. I'm getting out.
Well, please, you've got to help me. If she sees you here...
It's too late. She already knows I'm here. I just told her to wait a minute. Some mother you make. Some people want to have kids.
You can shut up. Well?
Well, what?
Well, who was that man? Charlie. Oh, Charlie and I go back years. Oh, there's no harm in looking up an old acquaintance, really, is there, Mrs. Morris?
Just as long as he's not one of your old business acquaintances.
Hey, what do you mean? You don't think I'm back on the game or something, do you?
Frankly, Chrissie, yes, I do.
Yeah, well, I'm not, see? I might be hard up, but I'm not that broke.
I had a visitor this morning.
Yeah?
Derek.
I'm not interested.
Chrissie, your father's in hospital. He's not expected to live.
Good riddance.
So Derek's attitude was almost the same. He knows how you feel and he wants you to think about that offer, if your father dies.
You can tell him to take a long run and jump.
Chrissie, he's genuine. He seems to really care about you and Elizabeth. Otherwise, why would he go to all this trouble?
Guilty conscience, maybe? Look, I don't need him and neither does Elizabeth, all right?
Child welfare may just declare you an unfit mother if I happen to mention Charlie on my report.
You wouldn't. That's blackmail.
Maybe. But someone's got to look after your interests, and I happen to think you're passing up a very worthwhile offer of help.
Screws, you're all the same, aren't you? Once a bloody screw, always.
Chrissie, all I want you to do is go and see Derek and get to know him better. I think you'll be surprised.
And you won't mention... Will you come with me?
No, I'm sorry. I've got to go back to Wentworth. Besides, you don't need me. He is your brother.
Yeah.
Surely you're not going to leave them there.
What do you suggest?
Well, the Pentridge officers are here. Why not force them out?
With hydraulic rams, I suppose.
If necessary.
No, that way we just wreck the cell and we can't lock them up again. No, I don't think so, Vera. They're not going anywhere. Let starvation do the job for us. If they're not out by lunchtime, they will be by dinner.
As you wish.
Now, I want word passed to all the officers. There's to be no comment to the press. There'll be no visitors. The less publicity this thing gets, the sooner it'll be over.
What about Birdsworth? She can't very well work in the laundry on her own.
No, no, give her the day off. Ted, Jim Fletcher here. Now, apart from officers, there's to be no one allowed through the gate without my permission. Except Mr. Douglas, of course. Right.
Shall I lock her in her cell?
Who?
Birdsworth.
No. No, I tell you what. Let her roam around the building. Let her talk to the others. You never know. She might be able to persuade them to give up.
Hey, they've given Lizzie the run of the place. I wonder why they haven't locked her up.
Yeah.
Bet it wasn't Vinegar's idea and there's no way the old bugger isn't up to something. Hey, maybe we could get her to pinch some more food for us.
You know, I've been thinking that. Give us a hand to move this furniture. If she's gonna pinch things, we have to make her able to give it to us.
Yeah. You know, we weren't too bright, you know. I mean, two packets of biscuits and a block of chocolate is not what you'd call good planning.
Well, we had to get them while they were angry. I mean, if they had time to think about it, they probably wouldn't have helped us.
Yeah, I suppose. Door. Judith.
What are you doing?
Looks as though the screws have forgotten about me. They said I didn't even have to work.
There's not much point, is there?
Open it.
Oh, Jude, why don't you give it up? You can't beat them. It'll only make things worse.
Lizzie, they shanghaied B. We've got to show them that they can't do that to us. What's up with you? You've never been scared of a fight before.
It was always a bit of a giggle before, but this time it's dead serious. Them screws from Pentridge are talking about bashing the door down and dragging you out.
Lizzie, we've gone this far. Now, we can't back down. I mean, everyone's in it together. Come on, won't you help us?
But this isn't a game anymore. Oh, I'm too old for all this. Oh.
Maybe she's right, Jude. What good is it all going to do?
You know, I wish there was just some way we could get to the newspapers.
Morning, Ted.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Morris, I can't let you in.
What?
Governor's orders. No one but officers.
I'm sure Mrs. Davidson didn't mean me. Could you find her?
Well, Mr. Fletcher's acting governor at the moment, but I'll check. I'll just let Mr. Douglas in.
Oh, good morning, sir. Seems I've been locked out.
Really? I'm sure there's a mistake there. I'll authorize Mrs. Morris. Care for a lift?
Oh, thank you. What's going on?
Oh, a minor spot of trouble. We decided to transfer B. Smith to Barnhurst, and the women decided they didn't like it.
I can imagine.
Good, it must be nearly lunchtime. We thought you'd like a sleep in after your midnight trip. Come on, Frieda. You'll have plenty of time to meet the infamous B. Smith later.
What's with her?
Evidently, your reputation has arrived ahead of you. Some people are impressed by that. I'm not.
Fair enough. Is this it, or do I get out of here?
Well, think about it.
I'm sorry, I didn't catch your name.
Mrs. Roberts.
Mrs. Roberts, you wouldn't happen to have a match by any chance, would you?
Smoking's a health hazard, you know.
Yeah, well, I like to live dangerously.
Is that so? That's a habit we discourage here at Barnhurst.
Oh, no. Another bloody Vera.
Yes. You must be Brenda.
Yes.
I'm Chrissie. I'm Derek's sister.
Oh. You'd better come in then.
Ta.
Have a seat. Derek's not here at the moment. He's at the hospital with his... your father.
Yeah, I heard he was sick.
Derek's told me about you.
Oh, yeah? We had our differences as kids. You know what brothers and sisters are like, fighting all the time.
You've been in prison.
Yeah.
Murder, wasn't it?
Manslaughter. Yeah, they gave me this psychiatric report that said I'd lashed out in anger.
Psychiatric?
Yeah. Well, you got to be mad in the first place, really, ain't you, to get caught?
Excuse me. Hello, 1193621. Yes, love. Oh. You okay? All right. See you when you get home. That was Derek. Your father died 15 minutes ago.
I suppose I ought to feel different somehow.
Why? Because the old bastard's dead, I don't. I'm surprised you looked after him all them years.
Yeah, well, I just felt sorry for him, I suppose.
He went to pieces after Mum died. Anyway, look, we got the future to look to now, haven't we? Have you thought any more about what I asked you?
Yeah, I have, Derek. The answer's still no.
Oh, why, Chris? I mean, bloody hell, look, you're the only family I've got. I want to make up for all those years.
Yeah, I know, Derek. And I appreciate it, honest. It's just that I want to work this one out for myself, all right?
I just don't understand it. I mean, we're offering you a good home to bring up your kid.
I'm sure Chrissie knows her own mind, Derek.
Look, it's just all them years inside, you sort of forget who you are. Everybody's telling you what to do and when to do it. You stop thinking for yourself, you know? And I've got to learn all over again, haven't I? And I've got the baby to think of.
Yeah, well, what if they won't let you have her because you haven't got a decent home? You're taking a risk, you know, Chrissie.
Oh, get her, don't worry. I'm not going to give them any excuse to keep her from me, am I? Oh, God, that reminds me. I'd better get off to the CES, see if they've got any jobs going.
Hey, can't you stay a bit longer?
Oh, no, Derek, the way things are nowadays, 5 minutes makes all the difference.
Yeah, well, look, you'll keep in touch, won't you?
Yeah, of course I will. You're the only family I've got. Ta-da.
Goodbye. It's been nice meeting you.
Bye.
See ya.
For heaven's sake, Derek, stop pestering her to come and live here.
Oh, Bren, look, I owe her a lot.
You owed your father nothing, and we had to have him here with us for years. Beer bottles all over the place, rooms stinking of grog, drunken abuse. Just for once, Derek, I'd like to share the house with my husband. No one else.
Oh, for crying out loud. I don't bloody whinge when you drag me off to your mother's or your sister's or your bloody Aunt Fanny's, do I? Look, she needs our help, and I'm not going to turn me back on her.
Why not? You did it for 10 years.
Right. And that's precisely why I'm not going to now. And if you don't like it, you can bloody well lump it.
There didn't seem to be any need for the extra officers, so I sent them back to Pentridge.
Well, I must admit, you seem to have everything well in hand, Mr. Fletcher.
Thank you, sir.
You keep the press out of it. That's a must.
But surely you're not going to sit back and let them starve?
No, of course not. The meals will be offered to them at the normal times, in the dining room.
But there's room for negotiation.
Absolutely not. I won't have the department dictated to by some ratbag fringe element.
Perhaps if I went and spoke to them.
Look, I'm sorry, Mrs. Morris, but if they want to deny themselves normal privileges, that includes access to welfare workers. Now, I'm sure you have enough work in your office to keep you busy. Hmm?
You can have your lunch in the kitchen, Birdsworth. I've got no intention of opening up the dining room just for you.
I'm not hungry, Miss Bennett.
Don't tell me you're joining your friends in this stupid hunger strike.
No, I just don't feel like anything to eat.
It's a pity your friends don't realize that it's the officers that run this prison, not B. Smith or anyone else. What good do you think all this is going to do? They won't get any publicity from it. In fact, they could all starve to death and no one would be any the wiser.
Yeah. You're right, Miss Bennett. It's silly to go without anything to eat. I think I will just trot along to the kitchen and get something.
Well, off you go. You said you wanted to meet the others.
Umbrella. I brought you breakfast.
Yeah, I remember.
Gee, we've heard a lot about you.
Can't say I see anyone I recognise.
Mari wants to talk to you.
Mari Winters, she's still here. Okay, take me to your leader.
Righto, you lot. G'day, B.
G'day, Mari. How's tricks?
Oh, much the same. How's things at Wentworth these days?
Oh, Davo's been doing a good Samaritan bit and the screws are coming the heavy.
Oh, vinegar tits, I suppose.
Yeah, and pal. Anyway, the women decided to jack up and I was the bunny who copped it.
So here you are.
Yep.
Life's tough at the top, B.
Yeah, well, you'd know, Murray.
Yeah. And I mean to keep it that way.
It's fine with me, love. I'm going to enjoy my rest.
I know just what you mean. You got any fags?
No, I'm still waiting for myself to arrive from Wentworth.
Like Frida.
Taylor.
How disappointing. The way Wentworth painted her, I thought you'd have come out fighting from the word go.
Right, that's breakfast and lunch you've missed out on. Let's see how you feel at dinner time.
Don't bother, we're not coming out. Not unless Bee's brought back.
You're wasting your time.
I want to hear the governor say that.
I am the governor, Bryant, and you know it. And don't think that the department's concerned about you, because they're not. Leave them to it, Miss Bennett.
What about Birdsworth? She hasn't exactly tried to talk them out of it.
No, leave her alone. At least she's got the good sense not to get involved.
For you. Oh. I nicked it in the kitchen when Mrs. O'Regan wasn't watching.
Oh, you're a beaut, Lizzie. I knew you wouldn't let us down.
It's not much. I've got to try and pass some on to the others, so I'll try and get some more at dinner time.
Thanks,
Lizzie.
Well, here's to the screws.
Damn the screws. Here's to Lizzie.
Oh, is it all there is to do around here? Best garden in the area.
So it ought to be all the slave labour they've got.
Well, unless you want to go to the school or sit in your cell making baskets, that's all there is.
Suppose you're right. I don't get it. Only two screws guarding the entire garden. And there's no fence, nothing to stop anyone from breaking out, nothing.
Well, there's only one screw usually. You must have them worried. Hmm. Anyway, wouldn't do you no good. It's 20 miles to the nearest town. They'd pick you up long before you got there. But it's an easy enough place to live as long as you get along with Murray.
If you don't?
She'll stick Janie and her mates onto you.
Janie, eh? It's as well Murray and I get along then, isn't it? Smith?
Yeah?
You'll be moving in with an old friend of yours after work, Tracy Morris.
Thanks, Mrs. Roberts.
You know Tracy, eh?
Yeah.
Nice kid. She's out with a working party today.
What working party?
Well, a load of the fellas from the men's complex go out on the road to work, you see. A couple of women go along to make their lunch.
Yeah, is that right?
Yeah, good lurk it is too. Oh, she'll be a great old night when Tracy gets back.
Why is that?
The men collect magic mushrooms while they're out. And the women smuggle them back in the food containers. Hey, it should be a good haul too after the rain. Oh, everyone will be high as kites tonight. You wait and see.
Yeah. I'll wait.
Have a good day, Tracy.
Yeah, terrific. It's a second pot.
Freddie, give Tracy a hand with those pots, will you?
No worries, Murray. Friend of yours is here, Trace.
Hello, Tracy. I see you're up to your old tricks again.
Smith, your things have arrived from Wentworth. Come and collect them. Morris, you come too. Smith will be sharing your cell.
That one yours?
Yes, but you can have it if you like.
Just testing. Those bludgers are pinched for cigarettes. Just as well I don't trust anyone, isn't it?
You know about the mushrooms, don't you?
Yep.
Well, they're not really drugs, Bee.
Aren't they? It's news to me. Maybe you should tell me about them.
So you can get stoned on them. But I wasn't selling them. I wasn't trafficking or anything.
They cause hallucinations, don't they?
I don't know.
Like LSD?
I'm not into that.
Yeah, well, my daughter was. Experimenting, she called it.
Bee, I had to bring them in. They would have bashed me if I hadn't. and they would have got them in some other way. You're not going to try and stop them, are you? You'll be taking on Janie and Marie, the whole lot of them.
I'm not going to do anything about anything. Yet.
Oh, gee, every time I shut my eyes, I see this great big hamburger with the lot.
Oh, God.
Do you reckon we could eat the other piece of bread, Jude?
All right, honey. I suppose we can get Lizzie to get us some more tomorrow. Not much left. Still, should keep us going for a while.
Yeah, providing she doesn't get caught. Mm. I don't think the other girls are going to last out much longer with us, you know. Especially when they start getting real hungry.
Yeah, you're right. We're going to have to think of another way to force the screw's hands.
Fat chance we've got of doing that stuck in here.
Well, that might not be true, you know. I've been thinking about an idea that could work. I'm going to get Lizzie cracking on it tomorrow.
Well, it's got to work, Jude. Got to get B back here somehow.
Yeah.
Hi. Oh, it's you. Come in.
Huh. Derek in? I've got to tell him the good news. I got myself a job today.
Oh, good. Look, he's out at the moment. He's telling some friends about your father.
Oh. Oh, well, would you tell him for me then? See, I start next week. It's only a shop assistant, not much money, but it's better than nothing, isn't it?
Yeah, certainly, I'll tell him.
Of course, you know, it means I'm going to get Elizabeth for sure now.
Chrissie, will you be moving in here or not?
No, I don't think I will, Brenda. Well, you don't want me to anyway, do you?
Quite frankly, no. I've had to share Derek since the day we got married. We've never had a day to ourselves. Always had to consider your father, whatever we did.
Yeah, well, if that's how you feel.
I do. I'm sick and tired of mollycoddling Derek's family. As far as I'm concerned, you got yourself into the mess you're in, and I'll be damned if I'll stand by and let Derek drag you out of it. Just do me a favour and get out of our lives.
Are you lot ready to come out yet? Your breakfast is waiting for you. It's the same deal as yesterday. If you want it, it's in the dining room.
Perhaps we should bring the trolley around here. Smell of food might tempt them out.
With all due respects to Mrs. O'Regan's cooking, it might very well make them more determined to stay where they are. Let Lizzie out, will you, Mrs. Powell?
Again?
Well, we've got to be fair. She's not taking any part in this.
Wentworth?
Thanks, Mr. Fletcher. Still not coming out, eh? Mm. Silly mongrels. I try to talk them out of it, but they won't listen to me. I mean, I could talk to a brick wall. I don't understand it.
As you can see from the prison report, Miss Latham's entire attitude changed after the birth of her child. Previously aggressive, she became a model prisoner and a devoted mother.
Yes, they're certainly quite lucid.
It was this change which led to the approval of her parole.
And most positive report from her parole officer. One thing that concerns me is that immediately upon her release, she went to live with a known criminal wanted for escape.
Yes, well...
I didn't know, see. He never told me. We was engaged and everything. We were going to get married. It wasn't as though we were just living together.
The police didn't find it necessary to charge her with consorting.
And what about support? The current rent on her flat seems rather high for an unmarried mother.
Yes, well, she starts a job on Monday.
And the child?
I've booked her into a day nursery at the local church.
She has several previous convictions for soliciting. I'd hate to think we were releasing the child into an immoral atmosphere.
Look, sir, that baby, she means everything to me. I know, I've made lots of mistakes years ago. But it's different now. And I don't want her to go through what I did. That's why I want her with me. I want to make sure she's going to have a good home with someone who really loves her. She's my baby. And if you don't let me have her, I'm going to take her to the courts.
That won't be necessary, Miss Latham. I think Elizabeth is very fortunate to have a mother as devoted as you. We'll approve custody.
What?
Of course. We aim to keep families together wherever possible.
Well, when can I have her then?
There's the usual paperwork, I'm afraid. But everything should be in order by this afternoon.
Oh, thanks. Goodbye.
Good day.
Bye-bye. I brought you some more grub.
Oh, thanks, love. Did you talk to the other women?
It's all set. Bev will be the first one. That was the last of the tucker that I could get.
Well, this will be great. It'll fill us up. How are the other women?
Oh, one or two of them are ready to give up, but the others are all behind you.
Well, do you reckon you could sneak us some books from the library?
I reckon I could. Screws are letting me go anywhere I want. I reckon I could walk straight out the front gate like I did before.
Don't you dare. We need you.
I'm only kidding, Jude. I won't let you down. Well, I better nick off. Here's your brand.
Oh, thanks. What the hell are you doing?
This is the reason you haven't joined the others.
No.
You're the supply column. Never mind, just get to your cell. You can stay there until Mr. Fletcher decides what's to be done with you. Go on, move it.
Thanks anyway, Lizzie.
Hello, Janie.
You're sharing with Bea Smith, is that right?
Yes, but I didn't ask to share
with... Tell me she runs a tight ship in Wentworth. Won't allow dope near the place, is that right?
Yes.
Well, that might be nice for Wentworth. But I hope she doesn't think mushies are dope. I mean, well, they're organic, aren't they? Like health foods.
I really don't know what she thinks about them.
Well, I better have a little chat with her, eh? Put her straight.
But I thought Marie had spoken to her already. Janie, Bea's not trying to make...
It's got nothing to do with Marie. I just want to make sure Bea's got everything straight. See ya.
Oh, Meg, what a pleasant surprise. Come in.
Sorry I haven't had a chance to catch up with you, but I've been really busy.
I know, I've been phoning your office.
Oh, good heavens, you'll never get me there. I sometimes wonder why they ever gave me an office.
You're enjoying it, aren't you?
Oh, well, it has its moments. This morning, for instance, I had to take Chrissie to child welfare.
Chrissie, how is she?
Ecstatic, I'd say. She's just been granted custody.
Oh, that's wonderful. I often used to worry about Chrissie, but I'm sure she'll be all right now. Thank you, Meg. I needed something to brighten me up.
Good. Now, I'd like you to do something for me.
Of course. What is it?
Please go and talk to the women at Wentworth.
I don't think I'd be allowed. And why on earth should I? Hadn't you heard? I've been dismissed.
But hasn't Ted Douglas been in touch with you?
I doubt whether anyone from the department will be in touch again, except to give me my severance pay.
The women have barricaded themselves in their cells for 2 days now. They refuse to come out and eat until you and B. Smith are returned.
Oh, dear. Who organised that?
Well, Judy Bryant, as far as I can gather.
Well, knowing department policy, I doubt whether they'll get very far.
Go and talk to Jim. I'm sure he'd let you talk to them.
Meg, I'm thinking of going away for a while. A family has a property in Gippsland, and I feel I need a break.
But what about Wentworth? I mean, aren't you concerned? Don't you care at all?
Concerned? For the past few years, I've done nothing but bang my head against a brick wall out there. If I'm not fighting the prisoners, it's the officers or the department. Of course I care. But at the moment, I don't think I ever want to see that place again.
Come in. Ah, Meg. What can I do for you?
Jim. Jim, I hope you don't think I'm interfering, but I'd like you to talk to Mrs. Davidson.
Why? No, she's all right, isn't she?
She's fine for someone who's just had their whole career taken away from them.
What's that got to do with me?
Nothing. It's just that this standoff with the women worries me. Now, I can understand their reasons as well as I can understand the staff being concerned for their own safety. But letting them stew will only antagonize them. There has to be compromise on both sides.
So where does Mrs. Davidson fit into this?
Well, I think you could end the whole situation by letting her talk to the women.
Oh, come on, Meg. She's been officially removed from her post. I'm the governor now.
How would it look if I go running to her with the first thing that goes wrong?
Please, Jim, it's the only way to get the prison back to normal and avoid bitterness amongst the women. If you try to starve them out, you'll have a riot on your hands within a fortnight.
Well, I don't agree. And the department has backed my decision.
Do you think they'll back your promotion as well?
What do you mean by that?
You're only acting, Governor. Ted Douglas knocked back your promotion once before.
Maybe so. But the last time I had to go to Erica Davidson for advice, I won't do it again. I'm sorry that she's been dismissed, but that's got nothing to do with me. The job has got to be done.
Hi, darling.
What's that for?
Well, I thought I'd paint Dad's old room, just in case Chrissie changes her mind. It needs doing anyway.
You're supposed to be arranging the funeral. I presume you are going to be there.
Yeah, of course, love, but if the boss gives me time off because he thinks I'll need it, I'm not going to argue, am I?
So we get one millstone off our necks and two others move in. Terrific.
Look, Brenda, Chrissie needs our help, even though she won't admit it herself. Besides that, I thought you'd like to have a kiddie running around.
I'd like one of my own, Derek.
Honey, we've been married for 5 years and nothing's happened yet.
And that's my fault, I suppose.
Now, look, I didn't say that.
You don't have to. I know you're not happy with me. You want your family around more than you want me.
Oh, Bren.
It's true. Well, you can forget it. Chrissie came round last night to tell you that she's got a job. And I told her exactly what I'm telling you. I don't want her moving into this house. If she does, I'm moving out.
All right, now listen. Brenda, look, there's something I've never told you. And that's why I want to help Chrissie. I let her down really badly when I was a kid. After Mum died, Dad just went off the rails. I mean, you know he used to bash us around all the time.
I know about that.
Yeah, well, with Chrissie being a girl, he didn't just bash her. He used to...
His own daughter?
Yeah. Anyway, he threatened to kill me if I told anyone. One day, Chrissie ran away from home. And the police caught her and she told them everything. And when they questioned me, I was too scared of my old man to say anything. Years later, when I came out of that remand home, I'd made up my mind he wasn't gonna knock either of us around again. Only by then, Chrissie had left home. I didn't see her again until now.
Oh, if I'd have known, I'd never have agreed to him staying here.
Yeah, I know. Look, I can't let her down again.
No, I suppose not.
Come on, let's get the ball rolling.
I wonder how long before they burn the whole place down.
And how many casualties.
Hello, Ted.
I'm sorry to bother you at home, Erica, especially under the circumstances.
Oh, not at all. Come in.
Thank you.
I trust this is a social visit?
Yes. Well, no, not entirely. Look, I am sorry the way things have turned out, Erica, believe me, but you know what the minister's like on one of his off days.
Yes.
Look, I'll be honest. I was hoping you'd do me a favour.
You want me to talk the women out of their cells?
What, you've heard about it?
Oh, I have my contacts. Frankly, Ted, I'm not interested.
Oh,
Erica, come on. We've been friends for so long.
I don't think friendship has anything to do with this, do you?
Well, professionally, then, you've done marvellous work at Wentworth.
It's a pity the minister doesn't think so.
Well, I think I can persuade him that he's acted hastily.
From what I've heard, the department was taking a very hard line on this barricade. They were quite prepared to sit it out. Why the change of mind?
Well, hunger strikes are one thing, but they've started lighting fires in their cells. We don't want Wentworth burnt to the ground, eh?
No, that would attract the newsmen, wouldn't it?
Look, Erica, I'm being pressured from upstairs to resolve this crisis before the press get hold of it. Now, I need help.
Well, what are you offering me? Do I get my position back as governor?
Well, no, oh, that depends.
Ted, for heaven's sake, let's stop playing around. I have no intention of speaking to those women unless I do so as governor. If I accept the position again, it will not be under the same terms as before.
All right, then. What do you want?
I want to run a progressive prison, not a concentration camp. Therefore, I want full rein to introduce whatever measures I see fit to ease the security burden on both the prisoners and the staff. I want the power to deal with the inmates and the officers in my own way and not have the department breathing down my neck all the time. And I want it clearly stated on my record that I was specifically asked to return to Wentworth.
Well, no, I'm not sure I can agree to that. I'd have to speak to the minister about it.
Those are my conditions, Ted, and I will not accept anything less.
She's dangerous, Bea. She broke a woman's nose last month.
So what do you want me to do, run away?
Just go along with her for the sake of peace.
Look, I have met a lot of Janies in my time, and I'll meet a lot more before my time's up, too. I'll deal with them in my own way.
Is that right now? I've heard a lot about the tough Bea Smith.
Well, Tracy, where are your manners? Go and ask the maid to bring in some tea for our guests. Go on, run along. I'll entertain our visitors while you're gone.
Running errands for Bea Smith, are you, Tracy?
Well,
you better tell the maid to bring a first aid kit. In the meantime, I think you and I'll have a little chat about mushrooms. The difference between Barnhurst and Wentworth is that here the screws don't run the place at all. We do. And for women like a little something to pass the time, makes life a little less boring. It's hard to get grass or pills or stuff like that. Not like in the city. Are you listening to me, you fat cow?
Are you talking to me, love?
Oh! Right! Now I've sat and I've listened to you. Now you hear me. I don't care what the rest of you bitches do in this funny farm. I just want my own space. Get it? Don't try telling me what to do. Because you haven't got what it takes!
You haven't heard the end of this!
Well, I hope for your sake I have.
Oh. God, Judy, why don't you sit down?
Oh, come on, love. Give me a break, will you? This is the only exercise I get. Now, wouldn't you think something had happened by now? Maybe we ought to start the next fire, huh?
Oh, I don't know about that.
Judy, it's Mrs. Davidson here.
It's Dava. They brought her back.
Is that really you, Mrs. Davidson?
Yes, it is. I want you to come to the office to talk this over.
Might be a trick.
Are you back as governor?
That's what I want to talk to you about.
You haven't answered my question.
I am not going to talk to you through the door.
What do you reckon, Jude?
Well, it's worth a try, love. Now, look, if this is a trick and they do shanghai me like they did Bea, it's important that you get the women to stick together, huh?
You'll try, Jude.
I think that's done the trick, Erica.
Come with me to the office, Judy.
If you've come to beg me to go and live with you, you can just get lost.
I've got custody of Elizabeth. I don't need you or anyone.
Wait a minute, Chris. Listen.
I want to apologise for what I said to you last night.
What's to apologise for, Brenda? If that's how you feel, that's fair enough.
I didn't know what your father did to you. Derek never told me.
What difference does it make now?
Look, can we come in for a minute?
All right, come on.
Brenda and I have had a talk and, well, she's going to leave her part-time job and stay at home and we're going to try for a family of our own.
Oh, that's really nice.
Look, the point is I'd be able to look after Elizabeth for you when you're at work.
You've already proved you can do it by yourself, Chris.
Yeah, I showed him, didn't I? I'm picking her up in an hour, you know.
Well, the room's yours if you want it.
I was a bit upset last night. I said a lot of things I shouldn't have.
No. You was right, Brenda, honestly. I mean, you and Derek, you should be on your own.
Oh, rubbish. We only fight when we're left alone, don't we, Brent?
Yeah.
Look, it'll work out really well. Brenda can look after Elizabeth, and then later, you can look after our baby. I've already started on the room, and it's going to be great. And there's a little storeroom that'll make a fantastic nursery. What do you say?
Oh, I suppose it'd be better than living here on me, Todd.
Then you will.
Look, I'm a real bugger to live with. But I guess we'll give it a go, eh?
I thought this was going to be a private meeting.
Mrs. Powell is here representing the officers' union, Mr. Douglas, the department. I would like to know what the women's demands are.
Well, why ask me?
Well, you're the spokeswoman for them, aren't you?
No, I am not. B. Smith is the spokeswoman, and look what happened to her.
I promise you no action will be taken against you.
Promises? What good are they? That's what we're all on about.
Well, if you won't take my word for it, why did you insist on speaking only to me?
Look, I'm only giving you my opinion. I know a lot of the women agree with me, but I am not the spokeswoman.
All right, that is understood.
Good. Now, we would like things back as they were before. We want no more hassling from those officers in return for no more accidents to the machine. That's only a vicious circle. And we want B. Smith back. It's not fair that she should be shanghaied for just saying what we all feel.
I won't have prisoners dictating to the department.
Judy, your views are very close to my own. If I am returned as governor...
You're returned as governor, are you governor or not?
Mr. Douglas...
If you tricked me out of my cell, you're going to have Buckley's chance of getting the other women out of theirs.
All right. But I won't have Smith back here.
Mrs. Powell, do you have anything to say?
Not at the moment, Mrs. Davidson.
Good. Now that I am returned as governor of this prison, I shall make a bargain with you. If you get the women to behave responsibly, then I shall work towards restoring the privileges we introduced before.
And what about B?
She will remain at Barnhurst for the time being. I shall review that situation later. Agreed?
Yeah, I guess so, thanks.
Well, that's the legalities over. She's just gone to get her. I'm really pleased you two seem to have settled your differences.
So am I. I don't blame her for going crook on me, but I'm glad that's all in the past now.
That'll mean a great deal to Chrissie's future to have a stable home life.
It'll be good for us to have a baby running around, keep us on our toes, get us ready for our own, eh, Bryn?
Well, there's no need for night feeds anymore, of course, but there will be a lot of extra work.
Oh, that's all right. I don't mind.
Hey, here they are.
Hey. You don't seem too happy about something.
Me? Oh, no, I'm fine.
You don't mind having Chrissie at your place?
Of course not. She's the only family that Derek's got. And we're in a position to help her, so it would be wrong not to, wouldn't it?
Go and see your Auntie Bren.
Hey, look, Bren. Isn't she an absolute darling?
You're gorgeous.
I don't know. It's funny, isn't it, the way things work out? I mean, after all the carry-on and everything.
Well, I never doubted it.
I want to thank you, Mrs. Morris. If you hadn't told me to go and see Derek, well, it would have been really tough, you know, trying to keep that flat on and everything.
Well, you just keep out of trouble. That's all the thanks I need.
I will.
Okay, then, Chris.
Yeah. Come on, Elizabeth. There. Thanks again. Ta-da.
Goodbye.
Thanks a lot, Mrs. Morris.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Yeah, honey, more or less.
right. Now, straight to the recreation room. And no talking.
How'd it go, Jim?
I said no talking, Birdsworth.
Come on, let's get out of here. He's in a terrible mood.
No, there shouldn't be any more trouble. The others are being let out now. I'll get Mrs. O'Regan to organise a dinner.
Yeah, right, Jim. Well, we had to compromise. But Mrs. Davidson is back as the governor, and she has promised to get our privileges back for us.
But what about me?
No, I'm afraid that Douglas is determined she will stay where she is.
Oh, bastard.
No, it might be all right. Davidson did say she'd try and get her back for us.
But if Douglas has said no, she can't do anything because he's the boss, isn't he?
I wouldn't be too sure of that. I mean, Mrs. Davidson is pretty determined. And, I think with a little gentle persuasion from us, we might have Bea back here in no time at all.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines. The sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around, last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known. Till I had to face the nightmare. Right.